Now we'll see one more GATE question, which is asked in GATE 2000 paper. So A is 2.0 into 10 power 30, B is minus 2.0 into 10 power 30, C is 1.0. We have to do x equal to a plus b, x equal to x plus c, y equal to a plus c, y equal to a plus b calculations, and we'll see the remaining question. All these instructions are executed on a computer where floating point numbers are represented with 32 bits. So maybe IEEE 754 format we can assume. Okay. So the values for x and y is the dash. Okay, that's the question. So if you execute these instructions, you will understand. Let us do that. First of all, x equal to a plus b. What is a? 2.0 into, let us take a first. 2.0 into 10 to the power of 30. B is minus 2.0 into 10 to the power of 30. So here we should do a plus b, correct? I would like to tell you one quick thing. The format for 2.0 into 10 power 30 in floating point representation using that 32 bits, we are going to use 32 bits like this. Exponent, sine and mantissa. So same pattern, other than sine bit, for a comma b, we are going to have same format. We know that, correct? Perfect. Now recall the subtraction algorithm. In the subtraction algorithm, first we will see exponent bit, right? So exponents are same, whether they are represented in XS127 doesn't matter, because both are represented in using same format. So easily we will understand that they are equal. Then we have to do what? Subtract mantissas. When you subtract mantissas, since the bit patterns are same, you are going to get 0.0 into 10 to the power of 30. So whenever you get zero result, whoever is following that your architecture or IEEE 754 format which we are following, right? So automatically the result will be represented using special format called zeros all, correct? Though exponent 10 power 30 we got, but we will be making all that exponent to zeros. But in XS127 format, it is what? 127. We will be writing 127. 127 minus 127, 0. But remember one thing, we don't use that, because to represent 0, we got 0 answer, right? To represent 0, we use e value 0, that means all zeros, mantissa 0, remember it. Mantissa 0. This is a pattern. Remember it. Sign bit, anything. So we can use either 0 or 1. So that is already we have discussed in special values, correct? Now we'll come to the second line, x equal to x plus c. We are doing x equal to x plus c. Here x is nothing but 0. Now c is nothing but 1.0. How to represent 1.0 in floating point? So here exponent we have to write something and mantissa something, but sign bit is surely 0, because positive number. So 1.0 can be written as 1.0 into 2 power exponent, exponent 0, 2 power 0. So here 1.0 mantissa can be written as 1 is implicit, then like this 1.0, 0 means all zeros, right? In that way we will write for a bit 2 power 0, right? Here it will be 2 power 0. So but 0 is nothing but 127 minus 127. Then we have to represent here 127, remember. Okay. Your intention is you want to write 2 power 0, but in XS127 format, we have to represent that as 127. Because 127 is going to be subtracted, that will become 0. So that's fine. It is unnecessary to write it, but try to understand the high level idea. What is going to happen if you add them? So we will be adding x equal to x plus c, correct? So this is x now. X equal to x plus, this is c now. We add them. How to do addition? Recall the logic. First of all, this e and this powers will be checked. Are they equal? No, right? When they are not equal, then we have to move this. What is the general procedure? This zeros. So we try to make it 127, correct? Recall. So we equate exponents. For that, we have to right shift mantissa by 127 bits. Doesn't matter. When you move this 127 bits, all zeros, again you get same. So you get finally, 127 here and all zeros. You have here 127 and all zeros. Then, what is the answer? X equal to x plus c. Now you add them. When you add them, you get all zeros, Correct. Now here you get what? 127, right? 0. Recall, it is 0, right? Because it is in excess 127 format. If you see this one, then answer is 1.0 into 2 to the power of exponent 127 minus 127, which is nothing but 2 power 0, 1. So 1 into 1, 1. So finally you got answer 1. So use common sense. Really, it is a popular arithmetic. Really, floating point numbers are popular. Really, they are representing our real numbers or floating, I mean our fractions. Then when you add 0 plus 1.0, if it won't give 1.0, then definitely there is something wrong with the representations, isn't it? So that's why if I use common sense, directly I can say that 0.1.0 supposed to be 1, such a way that floating point numbers might have been designed, correct? Otherwise, so there is something wrong with the representations or implementations. That's why directly without doing all this stuff, I can say answer is, that means x value is 1.0, right? Now we'll see y. So y equal to how much? For that we have to do y equal to a plus c, y equal to a plus b. Let us do y equal to a plus c first. So what is a? A is nothing but 2.0 into 10 power 30. We have to actually represent it in, I mean, if you want to know exact answer, so we have to follow IEEE format, correct? So 2.0 into 10 power 30, what I do is I write like this, 1.0 into 2 into 10 power 30, correct? Then 1.0 into 2 into 10 power 30. For simplicity, let me assume that, so 10 is nothing but 2 cube. Of course, there is an error, 2 cube is 8, but that doesn't affect our answer. You slowly will understand. Let me take 10 as 2 power 3. Then it will become 2 into 2 power 3. 2 power 3 whole power 30. So it would become 1.0 into 2 power 91. Correct? So A, I write from now onwards, 1 A, this 2.0 into 10 power 30 as 1.0 into 2 power 91. So how to represent that sign bit? 0. So there is a exponent portion here, right? There is a mantissa portion. So in the mantissa, now we have to write all zeros. Let me write complete thing. So this is implicit, but still I'm showing you, this is actually represented thing, right? 1.00000. How many? 23 zeros. Now this is about A, A's representation. Exponent value 2 to the power of 91. I am ignoring that bias thing, because for everything we are doing that x is 127, right? Let me represent in pure form. Okay, so there will not be any difference. If you want to represent in x is 127, you can represent. You have to add plus 127. Now let's take c, correct? So what is c? C is nothing but 1.0. If I take 1.0, how to represent? Sign bit is 0. Then 1.0 can be written as 1.0 into 2 to the power of 0. That means here we have to write 0 in the exponent form. Then remaining thing is 1.0, right? This one. So mantissa same. 23 bits. We have two extra digits which are guard digits, remember. So we have finally 24 significant digits, including this implicit bit. So but only we represent 23. Now two guard digits. Using that, we are going to do the arithmetic. So the first step is what? A plus C, correct? To do that, exponent should be equated. You have 0 here, 91. Then 91 times we have to right shift the mantissa of C. Then what happens? You see, first right shift, it will become, this 1 will come here. So 0.1000, so on. First step. Second step, 0.01000, so on. Third step, 0.01, so on. If you do 91 times, then what happens? It will become that 1 slowly will be moved, right? Every time that 1 bit is going right side. After 25 steps, because we have only 23 bits here plus 2, 25 guard digits, 23 plus 2, 25. After 25 around, so approximately, after 25 times, your 1 will be disappeared, correct? Because we have only 25 digits. I'll give you one another example. Example, you have only 4 digits, 2.56. You have this kind of number. You have only 5 significant digits, let's say. Okay, forget about guard digits. Let me ask one question. When I right shift the number mantissa, what is going to happen for first time? It will become 0.2567. because we have only 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 digits. Then next time what happens, it will become 0.0256. In that way, first time 8 will be gone, second time 7 will be gone, third time 6 will be gone. Next time you will get 0.002, then 0.000 next time, correct? In that way, every digit will be gone. So that many times you are shifting here also, then you don't get anything. Here you will be getting 0. After that, we will be doing addition. So I am following the add procedure. Equate the exponents, do the addition of mantissa. Then you get 1 plus 0, 1, 0 plus 0, 0, so on. You get finally 1.0000. Is it not same as this one? No, don't remember. Now, what is this exponent? 91. Why you got 91? You know the story. Because finally, whatever it is, answer you are getting exactly like representation of A. Representation of A is nothing but it is a representation for 2 into 10 power 30. Correct? Now, though I did a mistake, doesn't matter. Because I did a mistake, I took approximately 10 power 30 as 2 power 90. But exact thing if you take also, concept is same. Then finally you will be ending up with A only, because when you add, correct? Because C is becoming 0 when you right shifted that by 90 times, correct? So finally, what I want to tell you is A plus C is nothing but A here, okay? So Y is now A, correct? What is A? 2.0 into 10 power 30. Now we are doing A plus B. Y equal to A plus B. So actually here Y is Y plus B. I wrote A plus B, correct? It's wrong. So please correct it. So in the question actually it is given as Y equal to Y plus B. Let us take that and we solve the remaining problem. So Y is what now? Already we know that Y's content is A plus C, which is A, right? We got so far Y equal to A, which is nothing but 2.0 into 10 power 30. Now we will be doing Y equal to Y plus B. That means 2.0 into 10 power 30 plus B. B is what? Minus 2.0 into 10 power 30. Recall. When we did A plus B first time, we got 0, right? Same thing you are going to get now, correct? So it would be 0. Here you get 0. So finally, X is 1.0, Y is 0.0 is the answer. Okay?